I planted over 5,000 dandelion weeds in my neighbor's garden. Here's some backstory. I have a 4-year-old cocker spaniel named Charlie, and he likes to poop. I let him out in my front garden every morning for his toilet routine, same in the evening. We don't have a boundary fence on where my garden and my neighbor's starts, besides a row of bushes. Saying this, Charlie hasn't ever crossed or pooped past these bushes. Now, every week, I collect up said poop before it gets into a disturbing amount, and I've been doing this for the past 4 years to keep my front garden looking good and not smelly. One day I came home from work to find that my neighbors weren't happy that there was dog poop in my front garden. I instantly went to collect up what was there, and there wasn't much, and it was nowhere near the boundary of where our gardens met. Fast forward a week, my neighbors again complained about the dog poop being in my garden, however, this time threatened to hurt my dog if he continued to poop in my garden. This time I wasn't so nice about it and stated that it's my garden and my dog can do as he pleases. Now, I know dog poop can be annoying, but when it's not in your garden and there's no smell due to decent airflow and open front garden, is it really justified to threatening a man's dog over some poop? Anyway, after months of going with petty things and shade being thrown at me every day about having a dog, I decide to declare war on my neighbors. Now, I knew these people pretty well. They'd just moved in, and we let them use our Wi-Fi for a couple of months until they got theirs sorted. I picked up a few things about them, and one of them was how OCD they were. They cut their back garden every week, and painted the entire bottom layer of the house to match their fence. This was all the fuel I needed to exact my revenge. My first step was to start off small. I knew they liked things to match, so I painted my fence gate bright pink instead of matching it with my fence. This was my first small victory. They hated it so much, they begged me to correct the color. So I did. I figured if peace was an option, it was worthwhile. Then began the hate again. I had to come up with something so evil and yet genius that couldn't be traced back to me. This is when I planted over 5,000 dandelion seeds in their front and back garden. I figured I was in this for the long game. I did this under the cover of night and made sure to plant them in places not easily mowed. Fast forward 3 months and their garden was covered in weeds. They grew through all the slabbing and were patched all over the garden. It took them over 3 days to clear the weeds and around 100 pounds worth of weed killer. Long story short, jerk neighbor threatens to hurt my doggo, I plant 5,000 weeds in their garden. Edit, I see a lot of people commenting on leaving dog poop in my garden. First, he's a cocker spaniel, he isn't taking colossal craps. It's also a fairly big garden, there aren't huge piles everywhere. Dog tends to spread it out to mark territory. You'd physically have to search for it to find it. Regards to not picking it up instantly, unlike some, when my dog needs to go, he's going to go. Usually, he has a final poop before bedtime around 11 p.m. And edit 2, comments being made about my dog's lifestyle are completely false. Charlie's a trained gun dog, not some common house pet. Ugh. He comes shooting and camping with me every weekend, and regards to walks, he gets one early morning and a run on the evening. He's a very well-trained dog, and a very, very good boy. Our next story was posted by user Katarina Kiev, titled, Two Fitness Bullies in My Spin Class Throw Shade at Me in the Studio and on Social Media. I get both banned from the studio, one gets fired from her job, the other's illegal hustle gets wrecked. On New Year's Day of 2018, I resolved to get in shape. I was never overweight, but growing up in Russia and spending my very early adulthood there, I smoked like a chimney and my cardio was garbage. Going to college in America didn't help matters because I started drinking to go along with my smoking. I decided to start going to spin class. I worked at a marketing firm and chose a particular spin class because I received a free, year-long membership as a holiday office party present that year. It was a generous gift because it was a trendy, pricey boutique spin studio. I've ridden bikes my whole life, so I thought how hard can it be to ride a bike that doesn't go anywhere? But my first day in class was a rude awakening. It was clear that the class that I was attending, an early morning class for people to attend before work, was an advanced one, where a majority seemed to be already part of the culture and very fit. It was obvious I couldn't keep up. The instructor was really nice and told me that since I'm new, it's a good idea for me to ride up front so that I can watch him and copy what he does more accurately. Or alternatively, he can easily see what I'm doing and offer alternatives if I'm not doing things right. I thought, what a great guy, and what a great class. There were these two other students in the class, though, who gradually made my morning spin classes suck. Valerie was obviously very fit. She looked like a model and obviously worked hard to look as good as she did. Boris was her male equivalent. They were both about my age, maybe a few years older, but it was clear they were far more fit than me. They were obviously very invested in that particular gym's culture, in that they were always decked out in the store brand athletic wear. I'm not gonna lie, they looked good wearing it. They weren't a couple, but it was obvious that Boris had a thing for Valerie, and Valerie was aware of it and not reciprocating. Whatever they were doing, it wasn't my business. That thing about both of them being far more fit than me, they didn't let me forget it. For some reason, they seemed to take offense to the fact that I was riding up front. I can see why. The front two rows were filled with the very strongest, fittest people, the let's take a selfie sort of gym people. Except these ones seemed actually fit. At the same time, all the other super hot girls and guys, especially the guys, were very nice to me and didn't seem to care that I rode up front, whereas Valerie and Boris would always shoot these sideward, disgusted glances at me, or smirk. I'm not a confrontational person, so I wouldn't do the thing most would do in that situation, such as say, "What the frick's your problem, bruh?" I always go to class super early to dress up and adjust my bike. The gym has a policy, first come, first serve, when it comes to choosing one of the 30 bikes in the studio. I noticed a lot of other people show up early who were also clearly less fit than the stars that occupied the first couple of rows, but they seemed to self-segregate into the very back. I was still new, as it was my first couple of weeks, so I sat up front because I was still finding my rhythm. I'd sit right up front where the instructor told me so that I could watch him, and he could watch me. Every time he would come in, he would greet me enthusiastically and praise me for my commitment to fitness. It was a little wonder his class was so popular. Everyone held him in high regard. Sometimes in class, he would shout encouragements to the class as a whole, but also give personal shoutouts to certain students. Despite the darkness of the room, when the instructor said, "Great job there, OP, you're killing it," I noticed that both Boris and Valerie give each other a look and shake their heads, laughing. I never knew for sure why Valerie hated me, but I think it might be because we were both Russian and no one else who went to the early class seemed to be, and she wanted to be the only East Euro girl? Who knows? As for Boris, he followed Valerie because he wanted to get into her pants. Boris and Valerie usually showed up right when class was starting and the whole place was packed, and yet they were so entitled that there were always two bikes up front, right next to each other reserved for them. Despite the crowd, at 5:30 a.m. there were still a couple of empty bikes in the middle or back, but that wasn't good enough for them. I'd be right in the front row too. I got there early, and it was my right to sit wherever I please. And yet, despite them showing up at the last second, they shake their heads at me like I'm the one who's got a lot of nerve. Well, this goes on day after day for a whole month, and despite the fact that I'm no longer new and I'm starting to get more fit and don't really need the instructor so much just to survive the hour on the bike, I will sit right up front. I thought maybe the particular bike that I was selecting had some significance to Valerie or Boris, and that's why they copped such an attitude all the time. I always rode on the same bike. By this time, I was a bit chummy with a lot of the other women and knew their names, and we'd hug in the morning. I thought I should make peace with Valerie, if not Boris, who always sort of gave me a, "I hate you because Valerie hates you, but if there was no Valerie, I'd totally go out with you" kind of vibe. So, when I saw Valerie that morning, as usual, she showed up right when the class started and sat next to me. I politely asked, "Was this your bike before and you were used to it? We can trade if you like." She rolls her eyes and gives Boris a look. Like a donkey, he smirks too. She actually says, "You should sit in the back. We're motivating people up here and you're hogging the mirror space." There was a whole wall mirror in front of the classroom. I'm thinking, what is this, high school? But the actual frick, you've got to be 30 fudging years old and you're acting like this? And seriously, you may be fitter than me, but I'm just as tall and don't weigh any more than you do, or take up any more space in the mirror, and it wouldn't matter even if I did. We're adults, or at least I am. That's what I wish I said. Instead, I just put my head down and went on with class. Eventually, I got so familiar with the other students, because the same regulars would come to class every day, that we all became social media friends. I even became social media friends with the instructor. Well, I don't post much on social media. I don't show where I work or every single thing I do or my random brain farts. I just post the occasional photo. On one of these rare photos, where I admittedly was begging for approval because I was proud of developing abs, the spin instructor himself commented how proud he was of me. A lot of people from spin class also said nice things. I was friends with neither Valerie nor Boris on social media, but they both liked this instructor's comments on my photo, and my guess is it's because they both like to kiss his ass. They certainly never showed me any kindness in class, unlike everyone else who was supportive of me. I clicked on their names, and my suspicions were confirmed. Both of them practically lived on social media and took endless selfies, showing off their bodies, humble bragged non-stop. They also made no secret of who their employers were. Valerie tried to claim that she was a model, even though it was clear that her only real job was being a sales rep for a beauty brand. Valerie was only a model in the take a picture of yourself using your iPhone in front of the bathroom mirror sense. So Valerie, I guess that makes me a model too. These two were such idiots that they'd post really dumb things on each other's walls. It didn't seem like they really had lives other than to talk trash against people. I saw that they had one exchange where they clearly were talking about me. How do I know? Because they actually said my name and said that I was ugly and a wannabe and skinny fat and all this other horrible crap. They also talked a lot about other people in the class and said horrible things and actually named names. It doesn't seem like they were friendly with the other people. Even the very fit people, who in some cases were even fitter. In terms of the class, they were social media friends with the instructor and some of the other teachers on the schedule, and with each other, but not with anyone else. Anyway, I actually confirmed my suspicion that Boris was low-key thirsty. After the spin instructor made a nice comment on my picture, and Boris saw that I existed online, he sent me a private message asking me to go to coffee sometimes. I ignored the message, which is just as well, because the next time in class he ignored me and just followed Valerie's normal smirk and psh routine. I don't like to start drama, but I don't like being bullied and trashed either. I screen captured and saved a lot of both of Valerie and Boris's comments where they trashed at least a dozen people in our class, and then made a dummy Facebook account. I fired off every screen capture to the owner of the studio. Not just the manager of that particular branch, but the owner of the whole company in addition to the branch manager. I let them know that these two cretins were trashing many people in the morning class and creating a hostile, unwelcome environment. I was also nice enough to send the appropriate screen captures where Boris and Valerie named specific people in the class to those actual people. If their accounts weren't set to where only friends could message them or post on their feeds. In less than a week, Boris and Valerie were gone. both had their memberships revoked and were banned from every one of the brand's studios. Several other people that Valerie insulted were sufficiently offended that they sent emails to Valerie's employer. Valerie, as previously mentioned, made no secret of where she worked, about what a hateful, body-shaming person she was, and how such a person should not be any kind of brand ambassador. From what the other girls in this studio tell me, Valerie got fired from her job. Don't worry, Valerie. You still have your modeling career of taking selfies in your panties next to your toilet in your apartment. I had the pleasure of seeing some of the less patient, ripped, buff dudes in the class who didn't find it amusing that Boris was telling Valerie on Facebook that he could kick anyone's ass in class. I openly offered to let him test this theory anytime, anywhere. Unfortunately, Boris was too occupied up front getting his membership cancelled and being refunded and being told to never come back please to make such arrangements. See ya, jerk. Boris had a wannabe unlicensed personal training business that he talked about on Facebook, and several of the men in class who had legitimate training certificates shut him down with a quickness. There was always Starbucks. Maybe I'll go for coffee sometime and buy it from ya, Boris Ista. As for me, I still show up early, but I eventually find my comfort zone in row 2 now, or even further back. There's always new students, and I like for them to sit right up front so that they feel welcome. That's what it means to be in a fitness community. Everyone's welcome. This isn't some kind of high school cafeteria, you can't sit with us kind of bullcrap. I loved the class so much, I kept going into 2019 as a paying member, even after my free year was finished. In 18 months, I've posted 3 pictures related to the spin class. That 4-pack is coming in nicely, lol. From certain lighting angles, anyway. Goals. Haven't smoked in ages, still drink like a fish. It's the Russian in me, I think. I honestly hope Boris and Valerie grew up. I low-key hope they marry because they deserve each other. Though I also hope they don't breed because that much narcissism from 2 parents would result in a kid with lots of issues. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed these 2 stories. There's a whole bunch of links down in the description if you want to click any of them to follow my socials, check out Discord, check out Patreon, anything that tickles your fancy. And yeah, I hope you have a good day and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.